Let us begin Bhagavad Gita, verse number 10 of 8th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Prayana Kale Manasa Chalena Bhaktya Yukto Yoga Balena Chaiva Bhravor Madhye Pranamavesya Samyak Satam Param Purusham Upaiti Divyam. Bhagavan Krishna begins this verse with the word Prayana Kali, at the time of departure. In the last session, we also discussed a little bit about our departures. Every being has got its own departure. Now here we have to little bit analyze about death with open mind. The mind which is not endowed with fear, the mind which is not endowed with emotions. We have to analyze about our departure. That departure is unavoidable, isn't it? But we have to learn something. Every being which come into manifestation, they have to go into unmanifestation. That is what the law is. But we have to learn, because we are under the process. Whether we wish or not, we have to undergo the experience. Now, what is the birth experience which we had? We kept unknown while we were born. The much pain was experienced by not us, by our mom. Our mother had the pain for our birth. Now, you see, that the experience of birth is kept unknown to us. In the same way, why can't be the experience to unknown to us? So when we are analyzing about the departure of the soul, you should accept, yes, there is a journey after death. That mind we need. If you conclude death is the destination, after death there is nothing remains, then the discussion will go vain. The discussion will be helpful for what? It will be helpful to understand about the goal, and it will also helpful to understand about even the life at present. Because the present life which we think, it depends on the departure. We think for 25 years, 50 years, sometimes hundreds of years. Because some of the human brain thinks about global warming after hundreds of years. The global warming will occupy, and it will be cause for so many destruction that we plan for the future. Also, human mind do research on this natural disaster. The nature, so it has to support our life. That's what our expectation, isn't it? See, now we should have a secured life. Without analyzing this, how can we become secure? Whether we like or not, we have to undergo this experience, isn't it? Now, how we were born? How these creatures, beings, come into manifestation? It says there are only four ways. The old beings, they come into the being. They call it Andajam, Jarayujam, Utbijam, Shvetajam. That's all, only four ways. Andajam means born out of egg. The creatures, they come out of egg. That's coming into name and form. Jarayujam, coming from the womb. That is the second variety. And coming out of seed, Udbijam, all the plants, Shvetajam, when there is a moisture with a particular degree of heatness. If you dump all the dirty materials, you keep it for 2-3 days, definitely there are worms. So this kind, you know, the birth is kept in four ways. But the experience, who is born, he doesn't aware about it. That is the birth secret. And the same Bhagavad Gita also speaks about the birth of Krishna as Divyam Karma, Divyam Janma. The divine birth and divine karma. Because karma is the cause of birth, but Lord Bhagavan's birth has got, so it is divine, it is said as a divine phenomenon. But our birth and death is normal birth and death. So though we were not able to understand the birth and death of Lord Krishna, but we should be able to understand our own birth and death, isn't it? So you were born or not? Yes, I am born. How was the experience that you had? Can you explain us? You cannot ask anybody. Yes, I was born, my mom told, that's all. You kept away. Why do we keep away? Because that's how it has to be. The pain is experienced by our mother because they were consciousness. If you have the pain in the young age, your system won't able to tolerate it. So you are so vulnerable, therefore you kept away from the pain. You were kept in the same way. So when you are going to die, so death takes how many kinds of ways? Now what I mean to say, so how many the way the death take place? If you analyze, but you need not to analyze according to the physical level. Like death is because of diseases, death is because of some accidents, death is because of some kind of poisoning, means of, so because of poison people kill somebody, some people because of the weapon, because of the nuclear like bombs, war. So this kind of death is not being discussed here. So the physical phenomenon, how it would be, doesn't matter. Departure takes place or not. Yes, it takes place. So whether you are a healthy person, do you know healthy person's death, how it would be, how it should be? So how it has to be? No. Everybody we think that when I am going to die, so I have to die without pain. That expectation every one of us we have, that is possible. Swamiji, when Bhagavad Gita was wrote, at that time car, bikes and these all flights were not there. So what? So what? There at that time so many weapons were there, those weapons are not now. Like that all the time there were also accidents. At that time also we had enmity among the human being. So death means it's a normal phenomenon. So death is because of our karma phala. Now we are just little bit keeping away this karma phala. Bhagavan focuses only at the time of death. At the time of death and the person who undergoes the phenomenon called death. Only two things. Okay. So when there is a death, what should be, how it has to be? It has to be like uruvarukam eva. The fruit which is called as uruvarukam, when it is ripe completely, it keeps itself separated from the plants. Death has to be like that. The death has to be painless. That's what the death it has to be. And people also should experience the time of death it has come like. That is a healthy life. Healthy body, healthy mind. The mind which is lived awarefully, it will come to know when the death will take place. I have seen Swami Chidananda, Divine Life Society. He wrote, he just, you know, recently, I think 10 years before, I suppose, when I was in Rishikesh, he wrote. So within this many days, so I will leave this body and don't let the people just to do what to be done. That's what a simple message as a letter. He just had the trouble. All these meditators' death is different. Normal people's death is different. Animals' death is different. The difference is not able to understood by us. So for us, every death seems to be the same. In some of the ashrams, after death, the coconut is broken on the head. It symbolizes, you know, the jiva should travel through Brahmarandhra. Because in Shastra, it says yogic death is something different. Because all other death, it has got its own lesson, message to give us. When the soul goes through the mouth, in the last session also I told. So when soul goes through urinal tract or through anus, so they get lower cadre of birth. Adho yonihi, the birth will take in the adho yonihi, painful life, and the life which is surrounded with all kinds of difficulties. When they go through mouth, again human birth. When they go through ears and eyes and even Brahmarandhra. Brahmarandhra is known as Sahasrara. So that is an indication. It is not given completely. Why? Because you have to make effort to realize it. That is our individual effort. Even birth, we cannot have, any doctor even cannot say that how the birth is now they are doing cesareans. So that even while doing that cesarean things, they just take the baby out. But I am talking about normal birth, normal delivery. So we convert into artificial because now we say that because we have, we should not failure. If you have proper life, you won't failure. But we cannot suggest because we are not doctors. We should not open our mouth to comment on these things. But we have to realize the human body is a wonder because it is made up of Ishvara, not made of human effort. It is a kind of product which is being manufactured by Ishvara. It has got lots of wonder in it. And there are so many nadis and even Sushumna nadi. So one nadi is known as Sushumna. Ida, Pingala, Sushumna, this you might have heard from Yoga Shastra. That's what he is saying, Bhravar Madhye, in this verse itself. He says, focus on the time of the departure of a jiva. What happens? The jiva who is with attachments, he will be endowed with lots of anxiety, fear. So why we get emotionally distracted during the death? So anyway, death is painless experience. Painfully death means there is no painful death. Death means they experience. So they become dark, as I told you, one of my friends experienced in the last session itself. So painless experience is like a sleep. When you sleep, you will be keep or you reduce your pain. You will become in a state where there is no pain. Death is also in the same way. We need not afraid of death. Okay. Because this body is a machine. It has got its own time of departure, like, you know, the engine which this Dhananjaya Vayu, it takes out. Now we have to learn, when Bhagavan says, the departure, the soul which sets the departure, that soul should have been endowed with what? The mind which is not distracted. The person has to have completely focused mind. Chalena manasa. And not only that, bhaktya yuktaha. He should be a committed devotee. A devotion, so he has to be endowed with complete devotion and also supported by yoga bala. Yoga bala means what? Ashtanga yoga balena. So, three conditions. He should be endowed with completely focused mind and he should be endowed with complete bhakti, and also he should be endowed with what? Yoga bala means he should have undergone lots of practice, abhyasa. Abhyasa of what? He has not revealed. He will reveal in future. He says, Bhravor madhye pranam aveshya samyak. Bringing all prana in between eyebrows. Bhravor madhye, in between eyebrows. This place, in a technical term called Ajna Chakra. If you keep focusing in this place, you can see there is a kind of vibration. Why? So when you focus there, usually it is said, you know, all blood circulation is brought in that place, therefore we get kind of vibration. No, pranas are focused. See, all pranas, when you take attention anywhere, you just spend prana. You, that expenditure of prana, you will be lack of prana later on. For example, you watch a 3 hours movie. You become tired. Why? Don't move. You are sitting in the chair, but you become tired. Why? Because when you see that seeing, hearing and doing some kind of work, you lose your energy. We have to spend our prana. Like that, when you focus in the eyebrows, the pranas are, what is that? So assembled, or it has been pointed in one point, pranam aveshya, samyak pranam aveshya, sa saha tam param purusham upaiti divyam. So death is not normal death. He should have capacity to restrain all this prana. Restrain means, so you have to remember chitta vritti nirodha. He should able to control all the pranas, and he should able to focus in between, to establish in between eyebrows. Okay. Then the next words, yadaksharam veda vido vadanti vishanti yadyatayo vitaragaha yadichanto brahmacharyam charanti tatte padam sangraheena pravakshye. Now Bhagavan started describing about the purusham. Divyam purusham upaiti. He reaches to the divine purusha. Then who is that purusha is explained in the next verse, in this verse which we have read. But before that, so when you focus, at that time you are preparing your boat. Your boat means our body becomes like a boat or flight. Actually, this body is a flight. You should know how to use this flight. Therefore, if you are a spiritual person, you have to be careful with your eating habits. You have to be careful with your talking habits. You have to be careful with your body language, because when you set a body language, when you eat something, when you speak something, so you are just transacting with your prana, this prana and the prana which is connected with sankalpa. If you keep on thinking something, you will become tired. And that something also which is having negative impact, my God, it will take 2-3 days you to get rejuvenated. We call it, you know, a sports person should have long sleep. I had one tennis sports person. So that sportsman, he has 13 hours of sleep. Because he uses all the tissues will become damaged. They need, you know, they need to be rejuvenated. He should have proper sleep. He should have proper food. Proper digestion must be taken place. Then he can maintain the health. But here, a person, one who is thinking unnecessarily so many things which are not needed, then he will become tired. So if you would have continued your life like that, at the time of death, you cannot focus. You cannot focus even at the time of the work. Now, at the time of the death, must be supplied different words. At the time of eating, at the time of studying, at the time of working, at the time of playing, at the time of speaking, at the time of sleeping. So this all at the time means what? You should have lived your life with complete devotion, complete focused minded and completely yoga balena. You should have got abhyasa. Then you could bring your concentration at the time of death, because that is, you know, very precious time. You may get distracted. So now normally, you know, when you are happy, when you are peace minded, go and sit and practice. That itself becomes very difficult for you to focus in a place, isn't it? Therefore, Bhagavan Krishna, he just by one word, prayana kala. Prayana kala means at the time of departure. That's all, that's the life. Preparing for that proper departure is nothing but called life, the journey of life. Now he says, so when you focus, that has to be on the proper destination. The destination which was told in the ninth verse, again he gives in one more way. So there it was like a upasana. Now here it's a kind of understanding what is that vastu, what is that purusha, what is the Ishvara, how it would be and how it is being understood and assimilated. Just yad aksharam veda vidaha vadanti. Veda vidaha means the knower of Vedas. Veda vetha means the knower of Vedas. Vedas means what? Apaurusheyam. Do you know the meaning of the word Apaurusheyam, which is not man-made? Then who made it? The man means a human kind alone wrote them, but the content is not man-made. Mantra drashtaraha. The rishis who contemplated for the years, for the centuries, then they found, they saw, they experienced, then they wrote. They experienced these things beyond our capacity. So therefore it is known as apaurusheyam. The Vedas are apaurusheya, and the people who are well versed in that, they say this purusha as akshara vastu, an entity that never perishes. Akshara vastu. Then yad yatayaha vitaragaha vishanti. Yatayaha means usually the spiritual seekers, but always here the inner sannyasi people are sannyasi people, the people who have renounced. So who have renounced, mate, what is being renounced? All the ragas, likes and dislikes, who have become matured with their likes and dislikes. Have you become matured? Have we become matured with our likes and dislikes? So what does it mean, Swamiji, becoming matured with our likes and dislikes? Yes. When you give ice cream to your children, you just observe. So 3-4 children, so one among them, he eats his ice cream and he also bugs from others. So like we become victim of our own likes and dislikes, called immaturity. Number one stage. The stage number two is victimizing others for our likes and dislikes. This becomes danger. When you like, that your liking that victimized you. For example, you want to go to picnic. Therefore what? So in your mind you want to see the place Simla or Paris. Okay, nobody will come to blame us. Why, Swamiji, you taken the Paris as an example? Okay, the people are good. If you, people are good means all people are good, okay. So if you wish your urge, your longing to see the Paris, and all of your friends, you know, they were thinking to go somewhere. You bring, you know, as though very nicely you bring, you know, I have heard about one place, you know, somebody also was telling, why can't we make effort to go there? Then people ask, where are you, what are you talking about, which place are you talking about? Then, you know, somebody told Paris, you know, I think that would be also a great idea. So you will make like this. You slightly insist, it's, you know, victimizing others for your likes and for your dislike also. If you don't like, so you victimize. It becomes stage number two. And it is dangerous. And stage number three, becoming victim for others and likes and dislikes. So these three things, if you are careful, you become matured with your likes and dislikes. That's what, you know, matured people who are very effortful people to be as a spiritual seekers. Those people shout out for what? That is what called Purushaha. Edichantaha Brahmacharyam Charanti. Edichantaha means by desiring what? People adapt a systematic Vedic life. Now also you might have seen, so there are people who completely follow Vedas. I tell you, it's very fortunate people. That fortunate life, you know, it comes out of only Punya Phala. I wonder whenever I see the temples, I go to the temples, so I love to go to our temples. You go to Tirupati, Tirumala, and you see all this, every stone of the temple, it has got its own history. It has got lots of message to tell you. The sound which you get and that staircases, you should try to walk from down through the staircases. A wonderful experience. I go every year and every step it has got lots of message. You can enjoy it. That's what the language is. So you become what? That's a systematic lifestyle. The committing, with commitments, because every temple, it is a kind of physical expression of the Vedic message. You have to be very careful with our temples, because they are very precious. So a temple is a kind of exhibition of Vedas. You go, your life is not enough to learn from our temples. The mantra which are chanted there, and that activities which are in the form of festivals, which are in the form of puja, which are in the form of vratas, and which are in the form of even naivedya. Every deity has got its own naivedya. And even in the name of Prahara, so even in the Ratha Yatra, and so many, every temple has got its own chariot, the Vahana Visheshaha. So you have to give your lifetime to learn from that. The Purusha, so who is sought out by this disciplined people? Satte padam sangrahena pravakshe. I'm going to narrate you, explain you briefly. That's what he gives assurance. Now in the 8th chapter, it talks about serious seeker, the seeker who is endowed with nishkama yogaha, nishkama upasana. The upasana is a fine-tuned karma yoga. Upasana, which is finely tuned activity, means karma. It's very subtle, very powerful. That is boon of our Sanatana Dharma. Now, with the understanding of Almighty, it becomes more powerful. That's what, you know, Bhagavan assures, I'm going to teach about my own self. He doesn't say in this place, I will narrate you about that padam purusham. Sarvadvarani samyamya manohridirudhyacha modhyadhayatmanah pranam asthito yoga dharanam. Now he again gives some kind of techniques that we will continue more elaborately from next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om.